I'm using one-to-one printouts of the plans, which really makes it easy to figure out how much wood I need and how to cut the shapes out. Here's tracing the outline for one of the parts that forms the back of the machine, and cutting it out with a bandsaw. Part of those pieces have a bevel cut to them, so I need to mark that separately for cutting it out. And with the bandsaw table set at an angle, cutting out that bevel. Now just checking to have all the parts that I need for the back of the machine, I'm laying those out on one of the one-to-one drawings. Where the horizontal parts meet the posts, I need to cut a rabbit out of them. Having made all my horizontal parts, I can now just use one setup to cut all the rabbits out of all the parts. And now the second cut to finish the rabbits. A tenon jig would be ideal for this, but you don't strictly need one, so I'm just using my table saw sled. Here's gluing some of the horizontal parts together. There's these exit guards for the marbles that get glued to the bottom of the rails. Might as well glue those together just to give the machine a bit more stiffness. And now carefully positioning the parts so that they line up exactly with the drawing here. Now loosely inserting a few screws. And by tapping those in with a hammer, I get a divot for every pilot hole that I need to drill for my screws. The frame for the back of the machine is only attached together with screws. That way I can take it apart again for making more changes later on. There's a board that runs diagonally across the back of the machine, and here I'm using a center punch to punch through the center hole locations for where the screws for my wheels go. That board also needs some rabbet cut on either end to mount with the posts. I clamp the board to a piece of plywood just to support it while I'm cutting that rabbet. Now the second cut for that rabbet. I still need to cut a groove in that middle rail for catching the marbles. Here's my paper template with the groove where it's going to be. I cut a hole where that groove is supposed to be so that I can trace out its shape with a pencil. I tried to figure out a setup for cutting this groove with a router, but in the end it's much easier and quicker to just cut it out with a chisel by hand. Now smoothing that groove out a little bit by just pushing the chisel by hand. I want that marble to roll a little bit smoother on that groove, so I'm using some sandpaper wrapped around the dowel to kind of smooth out the rest of that groove. Now that's smooth rolling. It looks like that groove isn't quite enough to always keep the marble from rolling off, so I'm adding a little block of wood here to keep the marble from skipping out of the groove. I still need to make some sort of guide for the marbles where they come out at the top of the machine, and once again I'm using the templates to cut that out. That marble guide actually goes on an inclined piece of wood, but I want the top of it to be level, which is why these things are actually wedge-shaped. I'm keeping the wedge underneath the wood as I'm cutting so that the cut is actually vertical in the piece of wood. Now let's clamp those onto the inclined piece of wood just to make sure they work with the marbles. Seems to work, so now let's glue that up. And now for some testing, just because it's so much fun.